school reinforced that when I went to school with their
But it's okay to drink vodka or take Prozac.
It's not. It's better to smoke pot.
But exactly. I'm saying they push all these really dangerous drugs, but then go after marijuana because that's 86% of people that use drugs only use that. Without that, their drug war's over. But go ahead.
That's right. You're exactly right. And the church reinforced it. You know, went to church. And so by the time I was a young man and the government got a hold of me in the police academy, they even reinforced those beliefs more. So I believed that I was serving the greater good. I didn't realize that breaking constitutional law and taking freedoms away from people was causing more harm. I really believed at the time that all the corruption I was involved in was helping the movement, and that was to get drugs out of America. Ronald Reagan was one of my heroes. You know, Kevin Booth, I sell his film, the drug war film, that proves Ronald Reagan was involved in smuggling the cocaine. You know, I was arresting people with Ronald Reagan crack in their pockets. And it's just kind of the Oz screen fell. And what I thought was this big, powerful American voice turned out to be a little bald-headed, tiny man that
well, you know, the British 160 years ago used opium importation to take control of China and set up a police state and then overthrow it. So this is really a formula to bring down a nation as a pretext to bring in the military, which they now use in drug interdiction inside the country.
Well, it's worked. Look where our country is right now. They're successful at scaring the American people, and hopefully our efforts will help fix some of that by exposing these cops on camera.
Absolutely. You know what? If you guys don't have somewhere to go in 45 minutes, we're live on the radio, the shortwave, everywhere, but we'll be just prisonplanet.tv and internet, but then that gets ripped to the web and millions see it in the aggregate. Maybe we can do 15, 20 minutes into overdrive so we have plenty of time to cover all this and play some video clips from your film.
We'd love to stay. We're honored.
Okay. I thought you lived in North Texas. I'm glad to hear you're in Austin now so we can, because I'm a big fan of what you're doing.
Okay, great. We're big fans of yours. Our email box is full of people saying you've got to get on the Alex Jones radio show, and we don't solicit our own interviews. We have done two.
But it's good that we ended up contacting you, so man, that was synchronicity.
Oh, it was great. That was great, Alex. Yeah, thanks.
Okay. Now, I mean, there's so much to talk about here. On the screen, we were showing video of you up in a helicopter over pot fields. What was that?
Well, Candi is our public relations manager, and she got a call. Actually, 2 days before she got the call from Channel 33 News, we were pillow talking, having another one of our meetings, and I said, our second film, Never Get Raided, we got to teach people how to grow pot and sell pot and not get busted. You know, liquor dealers are allowed to sell theirs, and they don't get raided at 3 in the morning. I said, well, the most expensive part of this project will be to raise the money to get rent a helicopter, because I have a certificate from the DEA. They taught me how to fly around spot marijuana fields. And I was going to fly around, find a real clandestine marijuana field, sneak the film crew in, and explain what the growers did wrong from the ground for me to spot it from the air. 2 days later, Channel 33 from Dallas called Candi and said, you know, the DEA just busted 7 huge marijuana fields on Dallas City property, and they're 2 miles through the woods. No reporters will go into the fields. Do you think Barry would go up in a helicopter with us? We find the fields and sneak them in, you know, sneak us in for an interview. Candi said, well, of course.
Right, yeah. I'll call you right back.
And so within a week, we were in the helicopter. Candi and I snuck the film crew in. They got their interview for Channel 33. And then I remembered where the patch was from the air. So when we were finished with that, we snuck our film crew back in. And that's where I give the instructions that you see right now on how not to get busted for growing pot. And that was a field the DEA had busted a week before.
Amazing. And the film's just full of stuff like that. How do police officers that are still narcotics officers, how do they on average respond to you? I know there's thousands and thousands of police that have joined an organization that is, you know, former narcotics officers against prohibition.
Yes, leap.cc, law enforcement against prohibition. 6,500 politicians, judges, and police are saying the same thing to end the drug war. To answer your question, we get death threats from police, usually through emails. And I've kept those, you know, filed away safely. But they've emailed us horrible things such as, I hope Candi gets raped while you're in prison for releasing those films, and I'll see you on the shoulder if you ever come through my jurisdiction. So they're not happy about it, and which is unfortunate.
Well, because subconsciously they have a lot of guilt, and so they need to keep the facade going of what they've done when it's a CIA aircraft last year crashed with 3.5 tons of pure cocaine, meaning coming from source, folks. They're caught all the time shipping. They ship the majority of the drugs in. The drug war internationally is only against cowboys that don't launder their money with them. The head of the New York Stock Exchange back in 99 flew to Colombia and met on TV with the head of the FARC and said, invest your drug money with us or we're going to invade your country. There's an international loophole where drug money internationally is allowed to be invested in U.S. banks. That's how open their drug dealing is. They ship it in, but that isn't enough to keep it illegal so they get big profits. Then they get all the incredible profits on the ground in the name of fighting the drugs. And police, you can't deny that anymore. I mean, it's been in Esquire magazine. It's been on ABC News. I mean, it's on record that the majority of narcotics are shipped in here by the federal government.
That's right. And we spend $90 billion a year now in this war on drugs. And they still are using the propaganda to make us believe that this country will go crazy if we legalize the drugs. When the truth is, we give millions of citizens every day doses of heroin in the form of Oxycontin and hydrocodone. We give millions of citizens doses of methamphetamine every day, mostly to kids, in the form of Ritalin and Adderall.
And by the way,
and they're not burglarizing
100 million people. That just came out in 2008. 100 million people are now on serotonin reuptake inhibitors or Prozac class alone. 100 million. On the insert of that drug, it says it's in the hallucinogen psychotropic class and puts you into a dream state and is highly toxic to the brain and body and creates psychotic breaks, suicidal tendencies. It's all in the literature that comes with the drug. Meanwhile, no one dies of marijuana.
That's right.
And by the way, folks, I'm not some marijuana person. I don't like it. It makes me paranoid. It's just not what I'm into. I like a Budweiser, and I don't even do that. Now, at least most of the time, I try not to. I'm not a pot guy, and I'm telling you, George Washington smoked it. And until the 30s, you could walk into any drugstore and buy heroin, by opiates, by speed, by cocaine. Coca-Cola had cocaine in it, and we had about 1/10, and you can go look at the statistics of Americans using those drugs that are now. By making it illegal, it makes it taboo, makes it profitable. In just like alcoholism tripled under the 10 years of prohibition back in the 20s and energized the mafia, corrupted the police. The very same drug dealers, Skull and Bones is run by the British East India Company, that's Mainline News, founded by that company that had the world opium monopoly. By the 20s, they'd lost their world monopoly, and the papers are now declassified. They lobbied to make drugs illegal so they could jack up the price several thousand percentage points and then use it to corrupt police on top of their profits, because they'd done that again then 80 years before in China. And I know I keep going back to that. This is a program.
It is, and it's sad because we forget about our prisoners. Listen, to go into a cage, pretend like you're snatched right now into a cage. The concrete floors in those prisons and jails, they've been urinated on so much, the urine smells there. The food is horrible. You get a bologna sandwich.
And it's a college of crime. Stay there. We're going to come back and get more into this. We're going to go into overdrive today, folks, for a half hour. So for PrisonPlanet.tv viewers and internet listeners at InfoWars.com, the show will continue. For our huge AM and FM audience, everybody else, we got 40 minutes left. Stay with us.
Farmer, I make a living off the land. I ride a John Deere tractor. I'm a liberated man. With the rain, it hasn't fallen.
Barry Cooper's Never Get Busted Again, Volume 2, Never Get Raided. Former top narcotics officer, over 800 felony and misdemeanor narcotics arrest. Former canine instructor, trained by the DEA. Here's Volume 1, Traffic Stops. Barry Cooper is a hero because he is standing up and declaring the war on drugs is not working. Ms. Tucker Carlson, MSNBC. We're going to go into overdrive today on an additional bonus 30 minutes for everybody viewing and listening when the main radio show ends in about 35 minutes. But I wanted to go ahead now and play the trailer. I forget which one. Which trailer are we about to play?
It should be the trailer to Cop Busters Episode 1.
Okay.
It's on copbusters.com.
Okay. So we're going to go ahead and punch that trailer up right now and play that trailer from Cop Busters for everybody that is out there watching. Are we ready with that trailer? Here we go.
Ow! Free Yolanda. Y'all planted drugs on Yolanda, and we're going to get her released and get the crooked cops busted. If you're a good cop, great, but you're not. You raided my house and nothing's going on.
On June 3rd,
later found out she'd been charged with possession of methamphetamines. I found out that she had been set up, that the drugs had been planted on her by an informant at the behest of Officer Gregory.